Hey, what's up YouTube? I have an amazing tool for you today. This is the ultimate art slash AI art slash photography and completely free ultimate photo manipulation tool. No $1,000 GPU required, no gimmicks, no trial version, no limitations on how many images you can create or the resolution that you can upscale to block behind a paywall. It's just completely free and there isn't even any ads yet. I know, right? Don't believe me? It says so in their mission statement right here, completely free in the bold, and it'll stay like that forever, which is pretty amazing. Another great blurb from their site is, "So what's the catch?" And it says, "Nothing. Why should there ever be a catch?" Smiley face. These people are amazing. So I actually wanted to do a top 5 of image upscalers, but I found this tool and why even show any more tools? Now this tool does a lot more than just upscaling, and I just said upscaling to get you guys here, but the devs refer to this tool as the Swiss Army knife for advanced image manipulation, which that's pretty much what it is. It can do image conversion, upscaling, it has an RGB to CMYK converter for your printed art, which stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and key, which is a printing connoisseur's term for the color black. If those colors sound familiar to you, it's because those colors are the colors of ink cartridges, you know, if you ever replace them. This helps you get the best printing quality and the darkest blacks and vibrant color, which is very important when you're starting to print these things out. Another cool thing for printing is DPI enhancer. So this increases the dots per inch, which gives you even more detail. So you could print something out really big and not have to worry so much about the picture being too watered down. Some sites where you upload and sell images actually require that there's a certain DPI that you produce. So you can use this tool to increase your DPI. The tool also has image to vector conversion, so you can actually make those logos that you always wanted to make or have those really thick borders on the edges of your image. And there's actually a cool hack where you can make a how to draw book by using vector art and removing some of the pieces. First runner up is RGB to CMYK converter and DPI enhancer. I'm going to do both of these together because both of these methods are used for printing an image. I don't know, maybe you want to create your very own waifu cutout cardboard. Did I mention that Midjourney now does extreme resolution? So you can now have a banner of a cardboard and make the height extremely high and then the width kind of slim. Just in case you wanted a 5 foot high, you know, 2 foot wide cardboard cut out of, you know, maybe a girl in a spacesuit or something, you know, along that lines. Never mind. You're welcome, guy that loves anime a little too much. Okay, so nothing special, just pay attention. So the megabyte limitation, and yes, there's a limitation, but it's not behind a paywall. So everyone's experience is the same, and the limitation is pretty gracious. The limitation is 500 megabytes here. So that's like half a gig and 200 pictures. So that's pretty crazy. And you could do some bulk processing here and drop hundreds of images. Or in this case,
wait for it.
200s of images. Before you ask, the DPI enhancer has a limit of 100 files at once with a 300 megabyte limit. You'll usually see it right under the upload button, or if you scroll down a little bit, it gives you a lot of information on the site. Okay, so upload your image, click on convert to CMYK, and then it's in processing. You can actually do another job while you wait for your stuff by clicking on the home or scrolling to the bottom here where you can see the rest of the tools. Another way is at the top left, there's four squares here. Kind of looks like the Windows icon. Click on that and it'll pull up a tools menu. So to find your files while they're processing, just click on the My Files icon right there, and then you'll see here all the different things that you're processing or have processed for this day. And I mean by day, because if you scroll down to the bottom here, it'll say, please note, files will be deleted after 24 hours. In 24 hours, anything in here is going to be not in here. Then at the top left, you'll actually see the waiting time, and this stuff, take it with a grain of salt. You'll have to refresh the page by clicking on My Files every now and then. It seems that even though it's done, it doesn't update the process. You might still be stuck on the blue clock or in queues. If you click on the My Files button here, it'll refresh that page and give you an update here with this approximation, but this is kind of accurate. There's times where it's been done a lot sooner. All right, so we got our image, so let's check it out. So I'm going to click on the green download button right here. And the status says check mark, which means it's good to go. I'm downloading that image, and unfortunately it's in a zip file, but just go ahead and open that up and click on it, and you could just grab this file and drag it to your desktop or open it in here and save it. And this is what I got, and you can see the colors are a little bit different, and this should pop better when you actually print it out since it follows that CMYK color scheme. So let's compare that to the original here. The original is on the left. It has more vibrant color with RGB, which is our computer LED screen, red, green, blue colors. And on right is a CMYK image that would look better when you print it out. I'm gonna take that same image and drag it in here so we can convert the DPI and get it ready for some extreme printing. And as you can see, it didn't like the format of it. See here it says, please only upload JPG, JPEG, and PNG files. So that's what he accepts. All right, so I'm clicking on the four squares up here. I'm gonna change it to image type converter. So I'm gonna upload the file right here, which is a JPEG file. And by the way, you could actually just press F2 and then just erase JPEG and put PNG, and that will now be a PNG file. But let's just use this tool for the sake of the tutorial. I'm not sure if there's any loss in quality if you do that. So I'm gonna select that JPG, and I'm gonna select output as PNG, which is weird because I could have sworn it said it takes JPEGs. I'm not sure why it doesn't like my JPEG. Maybe I was looking at the wrong file. So I'm gonna click on convert your images, and let's click on my files to check it out here. So I'm number one here. It should only take like 30 seconds. So go ahead and click on this refresh button up here next to the close button. Okay, and that took 30 seconds. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on the download button, and it's in a zip file again. You'll notice that anything that has bulk processing will automatically put your file in a zip file. So I'm gonna grab it and drag it out onto my desktop and go back to what we were trying to do. All right, so I'm gonna go back to the DPI enhancer, and I'm gonna browse for a file and upload that file that we just extracted, which is this one right here. And very important, you have to increase the DPI, so just max it out. So I'm gonna click that and then go to my files and wait for it. Looks like it's gonna be pretty fast here. It says 0 minutes. All right, it's been 30 seconds. So I'm gonna click the refresh button and it's done. So I'm gonna go ahead and download it, open it up, and there it is. So that's your image with the increased DPI. And I can't really tell, but websites that you upload pictures to when you want to sell picture will definitely know that the DPI is low. So it should help when you print it out to give you more detail and finer quality. The amazing thing about this tool is if you do start to sell your photos, like to Etsy, Wirestock, or one of those online sites, they want you to have a DPI quality that's pretty good. And then on the flip side, some websites will actually require that you have lower DPI. Here it actually gives a pretty good breakdown on the site. If you scroll down on the DPI page, and it says about 72 DPI for websites, so they can kind of run smoother. But if you're going to print out a really big image, you got to throw it in here as well as that CMYK to get the best printing quality possible, especially if you're going to print it on a canvas like what's popular nowadays. People like to print canvases to hang it on their wall. You definitely need to do this.
Oh, hey there. This is the part of the video where I ask you to like or subscribe. Either or will make me a happy AI. I know you're probably thinking that voice sounds familiar. Well, it's the voice from Scarlett Johansson in the movie Her, where she was an advanced AI application. I made the voice using 11 Labs that uses TTS, but you can make similar voices in voice AI, which is free to an extent. I made videos on both of these apps, and I'll leave links in the video description. I also made a video on how to animate your static AI art images with an app called Sad Talker. I haven't used the extension in a while, so I left a Hugging Face link so you can get started right now. It has improved quite a bit. Okay, let's get back to it.
Now let's head over to Midjourney, and I just gotta find a quad picture here, and so we can take advantage of the Midjourney image splitter here. So I don't know. You know what? These are all upscaled, so let me just go find one and download it. All right, so here's the image that I want to use, or the quad that we want to split. So go ahead and click on it. Then there's a little tiny thing that says open in browser here. It's pretty easy to miss. Go ahead and click on it, left click. And now that it's in here, you're going to actually click in the top here. Then right click and copy that address. You want that WebBP address. Then go back into the tool and paste the URL. Choose the type of upscaling you want. And I think Cartoon's good for this one since this is a Niji 5 image. Balance and fine tuning I find is pretty good. In detail, I never got really good results with it. Now I'm going to click submit, and it says, please select at least one image. Oh, okay. All right. So you got to select the images from down here. I got confused with that. I thought the link wasn't good. All right. So go ahead and click on submit. And it seems like a lot of people are doing this. I'm number 142 in the queue. It says 25 minutes, but I bet you it takes like 10 minutes. So I'm going to come back in like 5 to 10 minutes and click on the refresh button to see where I am. I'm already down to 139 on the queue in like 10 seconds. All right, so the split photos from Midjourney came in, and look at the huge difference here. The image on the right is the one that it split from the quad, and the left one is the actual quad itself. So I just zoomed in. But of course, the quad one is pixelated, and look how detailed. Oh my goodness, you can go like all the way into his face like this. I still don't see anything. So it does an amazing job, especially with cartoons with my testing so far. Yeah, so you can just grab your quads for your link in Midjourney and throw it in here for free and get these amazing upscales for absolutely free. No strings attached. Okay, so let's test out the background removers. I'm going to browse for a file and select that PNG that we just created. I would just leave the intensity off. It seems that one actually kind of messed up my image. So this is the results from one intensity. And this is the results from two intensity. And both of them kind of removed their hair in the back. It did everything else good.
Okay.
All right, so I removed the background on three other pictures because I think the fairy picture was a bit advanced for the background removals. So let's try some other pictures here. So I got these three right here and they're all finished. So let's take a look at them. So the first one is this R that I made in Midjourney and it came out pretty good. If you didn't know, you can actually combine letters with a picture. This was a picture of a bouquet of flowers and I combined it with a letter until I got a pretty good result. The R is not as hard. Some letters like T for some reason are really hard to do. Let's check the next one. So the next one, it kind of took out her body and just kept her face, which is unfortunate, but there was a lot going on there. All right, we had some success there and with the letters, which is a lot easier to remove the background. One thing to try is to upscale it first before you throw it in there. All right, so I'm not going to go over the SVG or vector files. I don't know enough about them to kind of show you what they're for, but you can go down here into the vector tool and then start scrolling down to see some instructions, what they're for, and all this other information about it. You might actually have to download a tool called Inkscape, which is a free photo editor that's particularly useful for SVGs. So it's free. Go get it. I'll leave the link in the description if you're interested. Okay, this time let's grab a single image here and let's upscale it. Yes, there's a lot of sick and twisted pictures in my Midjourney profile. All right, so let's get this one right here and upscale it. I'm gonna save it right here. Now I'm gonna click on the image upscaler, then upload the file that we got. And we're gonna choose fine tuning for this one just to see a difference between that and cartoon and upscale. If you didn't know, this upscaler does a 4x upscale, but you can upload a picture that's like 10 megabytes. So you can grab a 2K image either from a Stable Diffusion or Midjourney upscale. Then you could throw it in here and you can get up to 4 to 8K, which is pretty amazing for free. All right, so the results are out and they're pretty stunning. You can zoom all the way close into the face and you won't see any pixelation. So it's a pretty, you would have to, I don't know, you could zoom all the way up here and it's still good. That's pretty amazing. And this is one of the best upscalers that I've seen that's completely free. As you can see, you could zoom all the way into these pictures and see all the little details and it doesn't get watered down. And I haven't even done the DPI enhancement on these images. I might do that and actually print these out. By the way, I made these pictures in Midjourney, but look how close I'm zoomed in and it looks pretty good still. So you can't really compare an upscale unless you have the older image side by side to it. So what I'm going to do is actually just make a little video at the end with some music so we can slowly look at the comparison between the two pictures. But yeah, there you go. An amazing upscaler with a bunch of other features. And let me remind you, they said free forever, no catch, and why is there got to be a catch? So they are committed and keeping this free and making this tool better every day. So go check this site out. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It helps me out a lot. And I just want to thank you for watching. And also thank you for the great comments in the last video. I really appreciate it. You guys are awesome. Okay, take it easy. Bye.